Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. And today we're gonna be actually going over a defensive ebook. I've actually gotten this requested a lot, saying like, "Hey, can you kind of like go over defensive playbooks ebooks? You only post offensive ones." And I've gotten a lot of questions about that, so I will be posting some defensive ebooks now. I've only posted one on the channel, and the one on the channel was actually my first ebook I've actually posted on this channel, and unfortunately it got patched, so you can't run it anymore. So it's a little outdated. It actually got patched, I think, like 4 days after it came out, 3 days after it came out. It was pretty sad, but yeah. Anyway, we're going to be in the Chiefs playbook, and no, I'm not going to be going over LB Blitz at a nickel 3-3. I'm not lame like that. Now, going over. So we're just gonna select for offense the coverage. We're just gonna select it like bunch, because that's like the most commonly used one, and we'll do trail. We'll do trail. Okay, and then so for our defensive setup, what you typically want is you want to have a fourth cornerback. So you want to have your three main corners, have an extra cornerback, because this is gonna be very crucial to this defense. Now, when you get into here, you want to have, you want to sub in your cornerback. So, sub your cornerback right there. Move over to Devin White. Let's do him. And then sub in the strong safety. Let's do Keanu Neal right there. Now, you should be using the strong safety. So, use this guy every time. Depending on, it doesn't really matter which side you want to do, left or right, whatever, it doesn't matter. Just make sure that you always use that guy that you subbed in. Always. All right, so let's get to it. So, after that, we're going to be going over Storm Brave. This is like an insane blitz, and it also locks up. But keep in mind, you actually have to have some pretty good corners. I currently have L'Jarius Sneed, Stephon Gilmore, and Tyron Woolen. I think I forgot his first name, but it's Woolen. And they lock up for me most of the time. You only need to make two adjustments, and it's pinching the entire team, which is RB and down on the left stick, or it'd be R1 down on the left stick. And then you want to crash the line, which would be left on the D-pad and then up on the right stick. This is going to be for that. That would be the same thing for both consoles, because they both have a D-pad and a right stick, whatever. So this is what it's going to look like. This is it. Now, this is where it gets a little tricky. This defense, if you have good intuition and you kind of like figure out what he's going to play, or like what kind of like what he's targeting. So if he's running a lot of corner routes, you shade to the outside. If he's running a lot of, you know, fade routes or something, or, you know, deep shots, you're going to shade over top. If he's running a lot of, you know, short routes, shade underneath. The problem is that like if you actually get that correct, this defense will be shut down. Like, they're not getting open. But if you make the wrong call, they're going to get wide open. And it kind of works like that, I guess, for every defense. But base defense like this, it should be completely fine. Now you're actually not going to be blitzing, but watch this blitz come home. It's actually crazy. So snap the ball, cover, and you get the defense right there on your, like, on them immediately. It's actually like insane how well this works, and they can't really quick snap you because it's two adjustments, and then all you need to do is pick the right guy. Now, if they are blocking their running back, put this guy up next to this guy right here that I'm hovering over right now. Put that guy in the back end position. Put him right on his hip and then blitz him. And stay right here. Snap the ball. And then he should just scream off the edge right away. Now, I will say, sometimes that guy right there might shift over because the CPU is kind of just auto-adjusting or whatever to what you're making him do. So, don't be surprised if sometimes it just doesn't work. And, you know, it will happen sometimes. So let's just go over that again. Put him right here. And then we're going to pinch the team. Crash the line. Snap the ball. Cover. You know, do your reads, whatever. And he screams off the edge. This defense is going to be excellent, all right? It's going to be pretty good. Now, if you actually factor in both LB Blitz and Overstorm Brave, this is going to be a lethal combo of blitzes. Because they're two different kind of blitzes where... Overstorm Brave, it still screams, but in nickel 3-3 LB Blitz, you can actually put one of your rushers in a zone, and I'm actually gonna go over that right now. So let's go over to it. Now, the way you want to run LB Blitz is that you want to press right on the D-pad and then down on the left stick and then contain. Now, the reason we're doing this is because we want these guys to come off the edge really fast, and if we don't contain them, they won't run around the guards, or sorry, the left tackles. Or the tackles, not left tackles. Anyway. Now, a big misconception I see with people is that they base a line. This is bad because in certain situations, when you base a line like this, you see like these corners over here, like they're just too far away from their man. And if they run a slant, they're going to get cooked. Like I'd say like 7 yards away from each other. So please, please do not base a line. It is like actually annoying that people base a line in like certain situations. It doesn't work. I'm sorry, but it just doesn't. So again, right on the D-pad, down the left stick, contain, and let's snap the ball. And we do this. You'll see that it comes around pretty well. DTs get in there. I don't like this as much as Overstorm Brave, but it will work in some scenarios. On some teams, Overstorm Brave might work all the time. In some teams, Linebacker Blitz might work all the time. So it really just depends on the team that you're facing and the guys that you have on your team yourself. So, yeah. Now, if you notice that he's actually dotting up corners a lot and you can't actually stop it, this is what I would suggest. So we're actually going to go back to coaching adjustments, and you're going to want to do this for both sides of the ball. But what you want to do is you want to put ball in your defense to play ball, option defense to conservative. You want to put your flats to 0, curl flats to 20, and then hooks to 10. And then select LB Blitz. And then we're just going to select trail again if we can find it. And now we're going to do the adjustments, right? And then we're actually going to put this guy right here to a curl flat. And you can just press A and then right on the left stick. Or you can just double tap the right D-pad. Right on the D-pad and then press A and then left right on the left stick. Gosh, can't speak. But yeah, that's for like quick adjustments. Anyway, if we snap this ball, you'll notice that he's playing pretty well. Well, actually, okay. All the routes are going to the left side of the field, so I should have ran a play with a corner. So I'll actually do that real quick. But yeah, so it's gonna lock up the corner and it's gonna take that main read away. And yeah, we'll just do mesh. That works. And then we'll do LB Blitz, obviously. I'm gonna block the running back because we want to make sure that we're always doing that, because I want to show that it works even against blocking the running back. Snap the ball. You'll notice that that corner route, it doesn't really get open. That main read, when it's going to through the progression of the route, it is shut down. Now, if you're noticing they're hitting the running back a lot and your guy can't actually cover him, either you want to do this and just put your safety further up while you're doing your adjustments, or you want to put this guy right here into a hard flat. And it's a little annoying, but on linebackers like this, on this play, you actually want to press A and then right on the right stick. Typically, it would be A and then left on the left stick, but in this case, he's going on a hook curl in that instance, so just put him like this. So, but you can just press A and then it will tell you, you know, like the stick, and then my face cam is covering it, but it will say right on the right stick in this instance. So, yeah. Now, when you do that, and he runs a lot of flat routes, I'll just put him like right there, and then we can actually... Here, let me change the guy that's manned up on him to a deep zone, and we'll snap this ball, and you'll notice that hard flat, he just locks him up completely. And additionally, if he's always running those flats, that will give you an opportunity to put that guy in a deep blue, or you could send this guy blitzing that you're using and then just user that safety right there. It's really nice because then you have an extra guy blitzing. So let's do that again. So wrong controller. And then let's do that, and then we're gonna do this. So we're gonna have all our guys blitzing, and then boom, we're just gonna do this, snap the ball, and you're gonna notice that everything should be locked up for the most part. The corners on the Bucks kind of suck, so you know they're not locking up, but in Mutt, if you have like inside shade and outside shade, you should be completely fine. But yeah, so this is my defensive scheme, this is what I run. Hopefully you guys enjoyed, hopefully this helped you out, and I will see you guys all in the next one. Bye. Flip a bag, now I'm serving a Tesla. Going back, shawty with me, I stepped up. GTA for the ops, ain't no less stuff. Shawty born to be my angel, yeah, I'm blessed up. Cooking right
up in the stool, got a chance.